Hello. So why did we start calling coronavirus as COVID-19? Why did the World Health Organization came out with this new name? As Shakespeare said, what's there in the name? Today we are going to understand what made the World Health Organization came out with the name, right? Actually, it was lately in the year 2015 that World Health Organization came out with the guidelines on the best practices for the naming of new human infectious disease. Best practices for naming of new human infectious disease. Now, what happened? What is the need? Have you ever heard about Bombay plague, Spanish flu? Earlier, the epidemic or these diseases were named after the place, either the place where they accrue or swine flu, bird flu, by the name of the animal through which it is alleged to be transmitted. And that went to that extent that in the year 2008, the Egyptian government ordered to kill the pigs en masse, sabko mar do, though it was not executed. So the name was H1N1. Aise hi, approximately a century ago in 1909, there was a scientist in Brazil who found out a disease named, of kissing bugs. And that disease was unfortunately named after him. His name was Carlos Chagas and the disease was named as Chagas disease. Now, what happens when you name a disease after a particular place, animal, individual, it brings a bad name. It comes, it creates prejudices in the mind of the people. So to avoid it, the WHO has to come out with a system of naming a disease. Now, before understanding what is the structure, you need to understand it's not only about this also. Even when cyclones come, you must have heard about that they have been called by different names. The Katrina or the Nilofer, right? So they have been called by the different names and nomenclature, though it is not the World Health Organization, obviously, but it's the different consortium of countries which name the cyclones by different names. Otherwise, the cyclone remains largely the same. So, ऐसे ही जब WHO ने ये कहा तो WHO ने कहा कि देखो इन जो prejudice create होते हैं it goes a long way. So now it said that what is it? या तो उसका नाम generic term पे होना चाहिए, ठीक है? Generic term समझते हैं आप? Generic term का मतलब है कि symptom of disease या फिर specific term हो कोई, जैसे disease affects its severity और pathogen responsible. देखिए पैथोजन रिस्पॉन्सिबल, व्हाट इज पैथोजन? पैथोजन होता है बैक्टीरिया, वायरस या माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म जो कि कारण है डिजीज का, व्हिच कॉजेस द डिजीज. जैसे हमारे केस में कोरोना वायरस इज द वायरस कोरोना व्हिच इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल. देखिए उसके बाद है ईयर एंड आर्बिट्ररी आइडेंटिफायर्स अल्फा बीटा न्यूमेरिकल्स. सी, this is very important for you who all are preparing. This year I can bet it will come either in CLAT or it will come in any judiciary competitive examination or public state public service commission examination, SSCs or any examination. And you should know. And earlier this coronavirus when it came, the problem immediately, it was named as SARS-CoV-19 and different names. WHO immediately gave a temporary name. The reason being, it has a threat. Kahin aisa na ho ke log kehne lage Wuhan virus. The Wuhan will be, name of the Wuhan will be demeaned. Or there is a, people have this notion that it has this come from bats or snakes. To aisa to nahi hai ki unke kisi ke naam par. So that was the curiosity, and so immediately, temporarily, the WHO came out with the name. However, this name COVID-19 was only assigned on 11th February 2020. Now, let us understand COVID-19 naam ko उसी स्ट्रक्चर से पढ़ के देखते हैं जो हमने अभी पढ़ा है. तो व्हाट इज द पैथोजन नेम? कोरोना. इट्स अ वायरस. कोवी, सी ओ वी आई. डी स्टैंड्स फॉर डिजीज एंड 19 इज द ईयर. सो यू कैन सी दैट इट इज कोरोना वायरस, राइट? कोविड 19. सो आई होप यू लाइक अ वीडियो. And if you want us to come out with more such interesting videos, please like and subscribe our channel, share as much possible. And you can also follow us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter at APS Judicial Academy. You may call us. And I hope you like the video. Stay safe, stay healthy. Dhyan rakhein, khush rahein.